Okay, today we want to talk about limits involving infinity. And the infinity will show up in two places in these limits. And so first I want to talk about these all involve rational functions and the analysis of what is happening for rational functions. So let's talk about again, I want to make sure we're on the same page. A rational function looks something like this. Maybe we call it R, one moment, R of x. And it's some P of x divided by Q of x. And P and Q are both polynomials. Okay, so we want to talk about finding those limits. We've already talked about one way to do that. We saw for limits that if the limit as x approaches c of q of x is not 0, then this limit of r of x is just equal to r of c, or in other words, plug in c to both of these pieces. So today we're going to talk about the case when this characteristic is not true, when we are looking at an example where q of x is actually, or the limit of q of x is actually equal to 0. Okay? So when I want to take a look at a couple examples. I have two cases okay. First is the case one is the limit as x goes to c of this p of x over q of x gives me some form that looks like k over 0, where k is a constant and not equal to 0. Okay? So I'm going to talk about this case where k is some number and it's divided by 0. Okay? So let's look at an example like that. The limit as x approaches 5 from the left of x plus 3 of 5 minus x. So if I try this trick, the two-side limit, and I just plug in, right? Try plugging in. Plugging in x equal to 5. Okay, and when I do that, I get 5 plus 3 over 5 minus 5, and I get 8 divided by 0. Okay, in this case, I just want to look at what's going on right close to this. This, I have some constant number divided by 0 in the shorthand notation. I want to look at a t-table to make sure we kind of understand what's really going on. And f of x. So when I look right around 5, so and I'm approaching 5 from the left, so I'll go 4.7, 4.99, and I want to plug this into the numerator and denominator. So 4.7 into the numerator gives me 7.7 divided by 0.3. Okay? And maybe I'll switch colors just so that we know this is 4.8. And this gives me 7.8 divided by 0.2. This next one should give me 7.9 divided by 0.1. And the last one, 4.99, should give me 7.99 divided by 0.001. I think that I should just have one zero after the decimal point there. There we go. Okay. Now, when we look at these fractions, you can see something. The numerator is staying about the same while the denominator gets smaller and smaller and smaller. So I'm dividing this number by an increasingly smaller amount. So when you actually calculate these, 7.7 divided by 0.3, here I get about 25.7, 7.8 divided by 0.2, and right here I get 39. 7.9 divided by 0.1 1/10 is 79, and 7.99 divided by 0.01 799. So this pattern of dividing by an increasingly smaller and smaller number means these numbers are just getting bigger and bigger. And that's the idea that you'll see when you have some constant number divided by zero, like we had up here when I just plug in 8 divided by 0, that you see this thing getting bigger and bigger. And in this context, we say then that this is going to positive infinity. And so we write in this case that the limit as x goes to the limit as x approaches 5 from the left of x plus 3 over 5 minus x is equal to positive infinity. Okay? We can look at the same sort of chart from the right, and I want to do that just real quick so you can see the difference. So again, this is the same problem. I'll write it up here. The limit as x approaches 5, but now I want to go from the right of x plus 3 and 5 minus x. And I just again want, I will still get, when I just plug in, I'll still get this 8 over 0 form. Try to plug in. So that doesn't work. And I'll try and plug in some values. So maybe 5.5, 5.4, 5.3, 2, 1, 5.01. And again, you'll see this fraction, like 8.5 divided by, and now this is 5 minus 5.5. I'll get a negative in the denominator here. Here I get 8.4 divided by negative 0.4. 8.3 divided by negative 0.3. 8.2 divided by negative 0.2. 8.1 divided by negative 0.1. And 8.01 divided by negative something like this. You see the same sort of pattern. And if you actually compute these, you'll see these numbers just blowing up as before. So here I get negative 17. Negative 21. Negative 27.7. Please check these along with me so that you kind of know what's going on. Negative 41, or hopefully really know what's going on. Negative 81. Negative 801. Oh, one there. So you can see these numbers will get increasingly, increasingly more negative. And those will continue to take a nosedive and go down and approach minus infinity. So we say the limit as x approaches 5 from the right of this function, x plus 3 over 5 minus x is equal to minus infinity. Since these don't approach, since the two-side limits are not equal, you don't have a two-sided limit in this case. Okay, so I want to take a look at this graph and what this might look like. And let's see, I want to maybe put this as 20 intervals of 20 here, minus 80, minus 100. And we know from what we know about domain, I know that this value of x equal to 5 is not allowed in the domain. We've seen that, and we know how to find that. So when I go ahead and graph these points right around, right real close to this disallowed value, here I get something that looks like this, then here, then, oh, here. And then as I move closer, I'm down to 40. Move closer, I'm down to 80. This thing is really close to this line and is taking these huge leaps as I get closer and closer. I know that this can never cross this green line because 5 is not in the domain. So as I get closer and closer and take even smaller steps towards 5, this will move down towards infinity. I get this huge gap. The same thing if you plot these here on the left side. You get kind of this behavior. And I'm not sure what's happening over here to the right of this blue line. I'm not sure what's happening over here. We haven't plotted any of those. But right around this point, x equals 5, this is what you get. Now, this behavior is called a vertical asymptote. So let's write that down. Vertical asymptote. So if the limit as x approaches c from the left of f of x is plus or minus infinity, or the limit as x approaches c from the right of f of x is also plus or minus infinity, then x equal to c is a vertical asymptote. And it's just that behavior that we just saw. We have this big kind of gap in the graph and these huge branches of the graph that are going to follow and shoot up towards infinity real close to this point of discontinuity and maybe even shoot down towards infinity. Okay? So, and I just want to remind you, we have that, and we saw that in the case where I get k divided by 0 as this limit, okay? So we're going to do case 2 in the next video, but let me know if you guys have any questions.